again, part three of best and worst of 2021 and what's coming up for 2022. So let's talk potatoes. Potatoes are probably the favorite crop that I grow, that my family loves. And I would say this year, I had grown potatoes the year before this year, in a smaller patch. But I would definitely just plant. We eat the red-skinned, usual size potatoes. I don't know the variety. In fact, what I had planted, I just got at the grocery store and planted. And then I had planted a bunch of heirloom varieties that I ordered from, I think somewhere in Michigan. And they didn't arrive till, I think, May, which is kind of late to get, or it might have been later than that. It was pretty late. So it was nice to have the succession planting, but I found out those did not do great and we're just not interested in potatoes that are like this big. So I won't do that again. That was a fail. And I think I could plant more potatoes in that patch that I have. I have a pretty nice big patch. I have a walkway in the middle that's way too big, so I need to like make the walkway way smaller, and then I could add more potatoes in there. But potatoes did pretty well. We got a lot. Now storing them is something I have to figure out, and I'm working on that. They don't store in my storage room. I have a room in the middle of my house that I use for storage, so it's not really cold. And it's, well, you don't want it too cold, but it's not cool enough for sure, I don't think, for those. So I have to figure out the storage for the potatoes. And then I also grew sweet potatoes this year. They grew very well. It took over half the garden. And I do want definitely grow them again, but I think I would like to do it in a different space. I don't know. We'll see about that. Because wherever they go down and root, they make potatoes. So they were going all through the paths and everything in the garden. But I definitely will grow them again. I also have to figure out storage for those. I did not have great success with that. But they're good too. And I love sweet potatoes. And I have some kids that love them too. All right, moving on to fruits. So I had planted blueberries this year. 6 blueberry bushes in the... in the vegetable garden. And I think some of them died for sure. There might be 2 still alive. So that was not a success at all. And I know that blueberries are tricky. I've heard that from many people. I mean, I know they're particular about their soil. But I'm not done trying. So I'm going to try blueberries again. Probably not in the vegetable garden. I'm probably going to put them elsewhere. I don't know if I'll make a blueberry patch or if we'll do something. I'm not sure, but I'm definitely going to try them again, because the few blueberries that I did get did not taste like blueberries that I've ever had before. They were amazing. I don't tend to like blueberries, but those did not taste like blueberries from a store or from anywhere that I'd ever had before. They were delicious, sweet and delicious. So they're worth trying again. So I'm not done trying. Strawberries, the only thing I would say is they did well, especially for the first year. I had 3 or 4 varieties out there. Now I had a patch originally in my other garden that I had transplanted some of those over, because I might get rid of that patch. I'm not sure what I'm doing in that area, but I would say I need more if I want to get actually a good amount out of it. I need to plant more, which I would have to figure out the spacing for that. And I also need to make better bird protection for what I have out there, because I have the bird netting kind of just draped over it, and we had a bird get caught in there and it wasn't nice. So I would rather have a frame, like a wooden frame with either the bird netting or something on it that you could sort of lift up off to pick and then put back down. Of course, that's going to involve my husband doing. I mean, maybe I could learn how to do it. But that would be more ideal than what I had. And then Alpine strawberries, which I didn't really know anything about before. I grew from seed. They grew really easily from seed. Tiniest little seeds. And they are delicious. They're a treat. So I planted, I did start more from seed in the later in the year and planted more out there in the fall. And I would plant more. And I want to get more varieties. I only have one variety. So they're a must. And they don't, what is that called? They don't vine out like the other ones do, like regular strawberries. And they're little tiny, tiny strawberries, but they are so delicious. It's like a flavor explosion in your mouth. And then I did put two grapes in, but that was later, and obviously they didn't do anything this year. I need to learn about pruning. I also need to learn how to protect them from those decimating bugs that are here. So that's something I'm going to have to figure out. Ground cherries, which I don't know if they're technically, I guess they'd be a fruit. I planted way too many plants of those. I had like maybe 8 in the vegetable garden, and they're very prolific. And once again, I found out I'm almost the only person who really enjoys eating them. So I only need 1 or 2 plants of those. So that's what I'll do. I did make a pie and I made jelly. I actually haven't tasted the jelly, so I don't even know if it's any good yet. I should probably do that since I gave people some for Christmas. And then raspberries. I planted some raspberries in there in the fall in the vegetable garden. However, there's an exciting thing we're going to be trying in 2022. That I'm going to take them out of there and move them into the new idea, which I'll tell you about later. But that'll give me more space in there too. I don't think that I'm already thinking it's a bad idea because I'm already having to deal with them coming out into the walkways and things. So those are going out, and maybe I'll put some asparagus back there. I don't have any asparagus. That's an idea. Anyway. Okay, and rhubarb. I definitely want more rhubarb. I have found how to use rhubarb, which I had 2 plants in the vegetable garden. I have 2 plants that I've had down, excuse me, in the secret garden. And I think I'm going to dig those out of the secret. They get crowded out and don't do well there. So I'm either going to put them into the vegetable garden with the other ones, or they're going to go into the new idea that I'll tell you about later as well. Oh, and there's, just to mention, since I'm talking about fruit, I had 2 currant bushes that I put down in my secret garden. There's a white currant and a red currant. And they were fun. I'm not sure if I would get more or not. Something I would think about, I'm not sure. We just kind of ate them. I didn't really know what to do with them. We didn't get that many anyway. And blackberries, my son has a blackberry bush down there, and I would probably consider doing more of those. That did pretty well this year. Although they didn't taste very good. I don't know what that was about. But that was mostly the fruit. I'm trying to think if there's any fruit I missed. I don't think so. I don't have a whole lot of fruit, so. The other thing I wanted to, actually I should probably talk about, I wrote this all out and then realized I forgot brassicas, which are kind of huge for my family. So I did plant cabbage early. I started them from seed, planted them out. They were the cute little pointy ones. And then I realized I don't even know if my family's going to eat cabbage. I don't even know if I want to eat cabbage. I can't eat it raw. It doesn't agree with me raw. So I didn't diligently harvest it, and the bugs got it. But then I did decide to harvest a few and try something with them. And they actually, once you got into them, they were okay. The outer leaves were not great, but once you went into them a little further, it was fine. And I found out my family does like them, like it sautéed with meat or other vegetables and stuff. So I will grow more of that and actually try to use it. So that was the cabbage. Broccoli, my family loves broccoli. It was an absolute bust. I got a few little crowns, but I didn't keep them covered, which I'm finding that even if you think you don't have to keep them covered, you should probably just keep them covered, because those, what are they called? The moths, the little white moths that come and lay their eggs on there and turn into little worms that decimate them, will decimate them, and they did. So I will definitely keep those covered. I also tried purple sprouting broccoli. I'm still trying purple sprouting broccoli. It's a really long, has a really long growing season, like, but that also got absolutely decimated. I even had that covered for a long time, but I should have just left it covered. And then cauliflower was a total failure. I know cauliflower is notoriously difficult to grow, and it was. And once again, it just got decimated by the bugs, by those worms. So I have to keep brassicas covered. I think that's the bottom line. And it doesn't look pretty, but if you actually want to get something to eat, you're gonna have to do it. So that's what I learned from that. That was the brassicas. And the brassicas, the broccoli and cauliflower are probably my family's favorite vegetables. So if I could grow those, that would be great. And actually get a harvest, a better harvest. So I'll stop there for this video. And thanks for watching part 3 of the worst, the best, and what's new for 2022. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.